Welcome to Watch Chat, where we chat about watches and other facts of life. This here is my Fake Daytona series, and this is part 2. In part 1, we talk about whether one should wear a fake Daytona. With so many benefits in wearing one, why not, right? But what about the legality? If you missed that video, I'll put a link in the description below. In this video, we'll be talking about 15 telltale signs of identifying a fake Daytona without having to open its case back. The last 4 on the list is probably something you can identify without comparing a fake and an authentic side by side. Before we begin, let me put a caveat here. The replica that I have here isn't considered the best in the market, but it is good enough to fool many. In case you are not too familiar with the Daytona and want to purchase one from the grey market, hey, do take note of these 15 signs. It might help you to identify a fake. You need to use a loop to look at this. On the genuine watch, the welding on the crown is pretty smooth and clean. The fake, however, will look pretty rough, especially on the side of the crown. The authentic clasps will fold and fit nicely as seen here. The fake, on the other hand, doesn't fit that well. The folding bar on the authentic watch is longer. The length is usually the length of the clasps and 1.5 link on the bracelet. The adjustable screw pins on the bracelet is usually screwed in from the left side on the top bracelet and is screwed in from the right side on the bottom bracelet. This fake Daytona, however, have it on the reverse. Both these case back is also different. The case back design on the fake Daytona looks more like the Rolex Submariner case back that I have here. The engraving on the authentic bezel are deeper and the color on the words and the numbering are in gray and maybe with a hint of brown. They usually have matte finishing, whereas the engraving on the fake bezel are usually painted in glossy white or off-white and the fonts are slimmer. The case on the authentic has a Datejust case shape with slimmer lugs. If it is a brand new watch, the polishing on the authentic watch has sharp edges on the case, bracelet and the clasps, whereas the polishing on the fake are usually more crude. That's because the workmanship on the fake are usually poorer and will require to go through several rounds of polishing to get the shape and polishing they require, which consequently compromise on the sharpness on the edge. The crown on this fake is slightly larger. The crown guard has a 145 degrees angle, whereas the authentic one has something like a 108 degrees angle. As for the pushers, there are usually some gaps in between the case and the screw holder on the pusher. In the authentic watch, the word "made" is placed in the center between the 27th to the 30th minute indicator. Similarly, the word "Swiss" is located in between the 30th to the 33rd minute indicator, whereas the fake has the words placed closer to the 30 minute indicator. The lume on the authentic watch uses chromolite, while the lume on the fake uses some cheap superluminova that also illuminates blue light that completely dissipates about 5 minutes or so. Because the hands and indexes on the authentic Rolex is made out of white gold, they are easier to mold. The edge on the indexes here has a rounder and smoother surface. The fake indexes, however, has a sharper drop-off on the edge. The body on these indexes are also out of shape, slightly wider. The rehaul on the fake has a slanting design. The authentic, on the other hand, has a straight rehaul, making it more difficult for the engraving. Both these watches have the word Rolex engraved around the rehaul. However, the authentic watch have every alphabet aligned with every minute indicator. The fake, however, isn't aligned. The repeated word Rolex on the authentic watch starts with the first minute and ends with the last alphabet on the 25th minute and begins again on the 35th minute. The fake, well, you can see that for yourself. In the authentic watch, the hue on the lume has a snowflake pattern and color, which makes it look a little dirty. The lume on the fake, however, has a flat white. The subdial on both these watches have a circular pattern around the black ring. The difference here is the painted numerals. The fake watch have them painted first before the circular pattern are pressed onto the dial. The authentic one, on the other hand, have them painted on top of the circular pattern. The edge crown on the authentic watch is more difficult to spot. It takes the form of small bubbles, creating the shape of a crown. The fake, however, uses sandblasting on the crystal instead, which makes it easier to spot. Hence, in this picture, you can easily notice a blurry image that takes the form of a crown. So, there you have it, my 15 telltale signs in identifying a fake Daytona. If you've got other telltale signs that I've not mentioned here, please feel free to leave your comments below. If you like this kind of video, please like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification button to support me, and I'll really appreciate it and promise to upload more videos like this. Until the next one, thank you for watching.